In this video, we'll look at how you can download and install Oracle 21c on Windows system. Here we're gonna use Windows 10, but you can follow the same process for any version of Windows like Windows 10, Windows 11, Windows 7, or even for Windows 8 as well. Let's get started. So first we'll download our Oracle database. So for that, let's open our Chrome browser. And here in the search bar, search for Oracle download. So when you search for Oracle download, in the first search result you will see the official website for Oracle database. So now let's go ahead and click on that. So when you click on that, you will be redirected to the Oracle database after download. So here right now, when we are making this video, we have this Oracle 19c, and along with that we can see this Oracle database 21c. And if you scroll down at the bottom, you have this Oracle Database Express Edition. We're gonna use our Oracle database for training and learning purpose. In this case, we will go with this Express Edition, which is lightweight and easy to install. So now let's go ahead and click on this link. So when you click on that link, in the next page you will see a different version for Oracle 21c. Right now for Windows we have 64-bit, and we have Linux support for the two Linux operating system, and looks like right now it does not have a support for Windows 32-bit. So now let's go ahead and click on this Oracle database 21c Express Edition for Windows 64-bit. So when you click on that, it will start the download for your Oracle 21c. In few cases, it might ask you to log in into Oracle account. So in that case, you can create Oracle account by providing the username and your personal email ID, which is free to use. Once you create your Oracle account, you can just log in using the same detail, and you can download Oracle software which is available to download. So yeah, our download will take some time, so we wait till our download is completed. It looks like our download is completed. Now let's minimize this, and now let's go to our download folder. So here in the download folder, you will see this zip file for your Oracle 21c. So now let's go ahead and extract the zip file. So for that, right click on that and say extract to this folder. So it's gonna extract my other zip file to folder called Oracle XE213_Win64. So once your zip file is unzipped, let's go to this unzip folder, and when you go to that folder, you will see the setup file. So for Oracle 21c installation, just double click on the setup.exe, and you're gonna allow app to make the changes to your device. Say yes. So your installation for Oracle 21 will start. So right now it is installing prerequisites for our Oracle 21c Express Edition. So we'll wait till it installs prerequisites for Oracle database. So this is our first phase of Oracle 21c installation. So here we have a message called welcome to install a wizard for Oracle database 21c Express Edition. Now let's go ahead and click on next, and here you're gonna click on I accept the terms in the license agreement and click on next. So in the next page, it's gonna give you the installation location. So right now it's gonna install under C, app and my user ID, and then product, then 21c. If you want to change it, you can click on change, and you can select the folder as per your preference, but I will go with the default. So let's cancel it, and now let's go ahead and click on next. So in this page you have to set the password for your SIS system or PDBA admin account. So by default it will have this three account. You can set the password for these three accounts, which will be common for all these three accounts. So now let's go ahead and set up the password for this account. So I will set as a sys. Same goes with a confirmation, and don't forget to make a note of this, because you're gonna use the same password for all your Oracle database login. Now click on next. So here it will give you the location for your destination folder, Oracle Home and Oracle Base. So which is typically under your AF, then account, product and 21C, which is our Oracle database version. Now let's go ahead and click on install. Now it will start the actual installation process for Oracle database 21C. So right now its status is copying new files. So right now it has installed our Oracle database 21C, and now it is trying to configure Oracle XC database component on our system. So we wait till this configuration is completed. So after 20-25 minutes, our Oracle database configuration is completed, and here you can see this Oracle database install successfully message. And take a screenshot of this one, because it has some information about your database, especially if you want to login into Enterprise Manager for your database. So I will take a screenshot of that. Once you save your screenshot, you can click on finish. So in the next step, what we need is we need the Oracle client to connect to our Oracle server. So for that we'll use Oracle SQL Developer. For that we'll download Oracle SQL Developer. So for that, let's go ahead and go back to our Chrome browser, and here in the browser search for Oracle SQL Developer download. So once you search for that, in the first search result you will see this Oracle SQL Developer download. So just click on that. So here we have this Windows 64-bit, Windows 32-bit, macOS and other operating system. So here we are going with the first one, which is Windows 64-bit, which include JDK 11. So now here you have this download. So just click on download, and you have to accept that, and now click on this download button. In order to download Oracle SQL Developer, you have to log in into Oracle account. So I will log in with my Oracle account. So if you do not have any Oracle account, here you have this one, create account. So when you click on that, you just have to fill up this email ID, password and country, all those details. Once you fill up that, your Oracle account will be created, and you can sign in into Oracle account using the details. So after logging into our Oracle account, the SQL Developer download is started. So we wait till our SQL Developer is downloaded. So now our SQL Developer is downloaded. So now let's close this and go to download folder. And when you go to download folder, so here you can see the SQL Developer. So now what you can do is you just copy this and paste somewhere in your C or D drive. So I will put in the C drive, and you just unzip it. So now let's go to this unzip folder, and inside that you have the SQL Developer. So you just double click on it. So it will launch your Oracle SQL Developer, which is the Oracle client to connect to your Oracle server. So now let's create the connection here. So here you have this plus sign, so let's click on that. And here you have to give the name, so which you want to have in your Oracle SQL developer, which is not your the actual database name. So I will say Aura 21c, and here you have this database Oracle, and for username I will use system, and my password is sys, and then hostname this localhost. Let's refer this our screenshot of the setup. So it says localhost and port is 1521. So here we have this host name as localhost 1521 SID XE. Let's test this. So it says success. For save it, now click on connect. So here you have to confirm the password for system. So I says sys. We are connected to our the database. So here we'll create our table. So I say create table my table, and I will say emp id, which is ent, and then I have emp name, which is varchar 50, and let's close this bracket and run it. So table is created. So now let's refresh this and let's go to our table, which is my TBL, and here you have this data. So you add this one and say one, and say add a chon, and here you have this commit button, so click on that. So one record is inserted into my TBL. So this is how you can connect to your Oracle database using SQL Developer. You can also connect to your Oracle database using SQL Plus. So when you search for SQL Plus, so here you have SQL Plus, and here you have to enter the username and password. So I will use system as my username and password. So now I have connected to my Oracle database. Now if I select from my table, so I have this employee ID and employee name. So you can run the SQL from the SQL Plus as well. So now we'll connect to Oracle Enterprise Manager. For that we have to use this HTTPS localhost 550EM. So for that, let's open our browser, and here if you search for that, so here it says your connection is not private, but that's fine. You go to advanced and go to localhost, so here you have to enter the password. So we say system and password is sys, and let's click on login. So this is your enterprise manager for your Oracle 21c. So here you have this performance tab, and you have the storage within that. You have table space, you can see this status performance. So right now our database is running since last 50 minutes, and you have this resources, and what is if you want to have some SQL monitoring incident, you can have all this detail about your database. Yeah, that's all for this Oracle 21c database installation process. Of this video will help you to install Oracle 21c on your system and give some idea how to connect to Oracle database and create the table inside Oracle database. And thank you for watching this video, and see you in the next video.